Hello, this is Chad with Syncfusion. Have you been asked to put a PDF file on your webpage? Maybe let your users comment or underline, strike through, add their own text? Maybe draw on the PDF file, arrows and circles and stuff? Maybe you've been asked to let your users do form fields, form filling, maybe even signatures. It could be that you've been asked to do a signature workflow into your application. If any of that is true, or might be true, Syncfusion PDF Viewer Control can help you get there. Here is our product page. As you see, this control is available not just in JavaScript, but in all these flavors of JavaScript. If we scroll down a little bit, we're going to see 8 really good reasons why you should use the JavaScript PDF Viewer from Syncfusion. I will let you read these on your own. I'm going to click on this happy little blue button right here. And actually, I pre-clicked the button for the purposes of this video, and it took me to this page. So I'm going to use this, our default functionality sample, to go through some of the features of our control. So here we support bookmarks, we support thumbnails. You can upload, open a file. This entire toolbar across the top can be customized. Actually, here is exactly how you would do it. Fully customizable. If you want to let your users do annotations, something like, well, let me scroll here and find a page that has some text on it. Maybe you want to underline or highlight or add shapes. Maybe you need to do some free text on the page. Or stamps. Now these stamps, we have a lot of default stamps that come with it. But these stamps are just images. So you can use your own custom stamps. Signatures and all this. We do support comments. So here's our comment button. And here's a link to the comments. The same panel here. Each of these comments, each of these annotations have some user ID, and it's up to you for this user ID to make sense in your application. All of these are annotations are kept as separate from the PDF file. So a very common use case is let the PDF be a pristine version in the database somewhere, and then the annotation objects are stored separately. And before you view the PDF or send the PDF, you put the two together, you flatten it so they're no longer objects, and then you send it out. That's a common use case. Let's see, we also support form filling. Let's talk about that. So this is basic form filling. We have text boxes, radio buttons, and that's not a date, drop-down list, a check, and a signature. What if you need to add something else to this? So we can edit this. We can add our own form fields here in this UI. And I'm going to add an initial. Let's say we have to initial our date of birth because that is incredibly wrong. But here we go. And I want to put some properties on it. So let's say, okay, there we go. Initializes here. If I close this toolbox, I'm now in edit mode and I can add an initial. So this is a basic, very quick overview of what the PDF Viewer control can do. Now, if you actually do need to make a PDF signature workflow, this control has all the base functionality to get you there, and you'll have to write all the code on top of that. If you're not too keen on writing all that code, we might have you covered. So I'm back here at our homepage, and I'm going to talk about this guy right here, Bold Sign. Bold Sign is an app we made to do signatures for you. It's a whole signature workflow application. You can use it as a SaaS app, put it behind your firewall, that's fine. But we offer a e-signature API. This will let you put the power of Bold Sign onto your application so it looks like you did the work. It's entirely up to you. If you need it, it is here. Otherwise, this has been a quick walkthrough of our JavaScript PDF Viewer control. Thank you for watching.